Authorities confirmed today the patients here in Montgomery County were on a cruise outside the United States. They returned home February 20th, but they were not tested until this Wednesday, 13 days later.
They followed the guidelines that they had.
According to Dr. Travis Gales, the county's chief health officer, the patients were not tested early on because they did not meet the U.S. Centers for Disease Control federal guidelines for testing. But as more information developed, the CDC contacted the patients. Here's Dr. Gales.
And there is the potential that we may see other cases tied to these index cases within our jurisdiction. But what I want to also emphasize that Deputy Secretary Phillips mentioned is that all of these cases are doing well clinically. And so that suggests that the severity of the illness, that even if it's here, remains in a mild to moderate category.
Gale said the discovery of the cases has touched off a large investigation to piece together all the people and places the patients may have had contact with. Citing medical privacy concerns, Gales declined to say how many people may be part of this investigation and which places.
There was very limited interaction with school-age children.
Gales did say the chances of contact with school children appear to be low.
We are not recommending any large-scale closure of any of our government buildings, facilities, including schools.
We've been preparing for this scenario since January, so we're not caught by surprise.
County Executive Mark Elrich reacted.
There is no reason to panic, and life as you know it should continue pretty much before as it was before this became news, with the caveats of what we're saying about precautions to take.
Sidney Katz is chair of the county council.
Community members should not panic, but instead prepare as you would for any event that may keep you at home for 2 weeks. This means doing things like making sure all your medications are up to date, having non-perishable food items in the home, and making contingency plans in case you or a loved one needs to work from home.
Scott Broom, WUSA 9.